The 1960s police television serials, Z-Cars, and its spin-off, Softly Softly, were probably two of the most successful serials to come out of the drama department at the BBC. Their success was partly due to Elwyn Jones, who was the BBC head of series. However, during 1966, Jones decided to step down from this position and return to freelance writing. Around this time, Doctor Who script editor Jerry Davis and producer Innes Lloyd were keen to phase out historical stories, which they felt were unpopular with the viewers. The Gunfighters, for example, had received the lowest audience appreciation figures in the history of the show. However, Jones was keen to write an historical story for Doctor Who, and so the production team decided to defer to Jones's well-respected status. And it was agreed that Jones would write an adventure set around the time of the 1745-46 Jacobite Rebellion. The Highlanders, which also went by the title Culloden for a time, was commissioned on August the 30th, 1966. At this time, the BBC Drama Department decided to revive Z-Cars, which had finished in December 1965. Elwyn Jones was called upon to reformat the series for twice-weekly broadcast for 1967, and to contribute to scripts for this and Softly Softly. This effectively left no time for him to work on the Highlanders. It was agreed that Jerry Davis could complete the work and receive a co-writing credit. In reality, Jones had only drafted a handful of notes, and so it fell to Davis to write the entire serial from scratch. The character of Jamie McCrimmon was a key ingredient of Davis's scripts. Davis proposed that Jamie was the son of Donald Ban McCrimmon from Skye, famed piper to Clan MacLeod. Both Jerry Davis and producer Innes Lloyd felt that Jamie might make a viable new companion, and were therefore heavily involved in casting the role that ultimately went to 22-year-old Fraser Hines. Hines had been a child actor in the late 50s, and had more recently enjoyed a recurring role in Emergency Ward 10. Hines had unsuccessfully auditioned for the part of companion Ben Jackson earlier in 1966, a role that eventually went to Michael Craze. On November the 2nd, Hines was contracted for the Highlanders. The contract also included a BBC option for three further four-part serials. Over the next 2 days, Michael Craze and Annika Wills were also granted a contract extension to cover the next three stories, beginning with The Highlanders. The Highlanders was only the second story to feature the newly regenerated Doctor, with Patrick Troughton still settling into the role. Jerry Davis saw the potential for reflecting Troughton's acting skills and humour in the character of the Doctor. And this is very evident in The Highlanders, where we see the Doctor donning a series of disguises and accents. His first guise is that of a German physician, for which he adopts the pseudonym of Dr. von Wehr, the German for Doctor Who, and he plays the role with a heavy German accent. This is followed by him appearing in drag, disguised as a washerwoman with a quavering hag's voice. Finally, he appears as a gruff-voiced English redcoat. The director assigned to the Highlanders was Hugh David, a former actor best known for the series Knight Errant Limited. Interestingly, Hugh David was considered for the role of the first Doctor when Doctor Who was initially being developed in 1963. However, he was uninterested in taking on another lead television part, and shortly thereafter embarked on a successful career as a director. Filming at the Ealing Television Film Studios took place on November the 11th and 16th. Jerry Davis had included scenes in his scripts that could be enacted at the facility's water tank. This was used extensively for scenes around the dock and outside the Annabelle. Between studio sessions, location shooting occurred on the 14th and 15th November at Frensham Ponds in Surrey, which doubled as Culloden Moor. These location scenes were Fraser Hines' first work on Doctor Who. At this time, no decision had been made on retaining the character of Jamie for further serials, and the scene in which the TARDIS dematerialised depicted only the Doctor, Ben and Polly entering the ship. Some days later, the decision was finally made that Jamie should be made part of the regular cast. So, on November the 21st, cast and crew returned briefly to Frensham Ponds to re-record the TARDIS dematerialisation scene, with Jamie now accompanying the others into the police box. Whilst on location at French and Ponds, Troughton apparently ad-libbed the line, "I should like a hat like that," in the scene where he finds a blue feathered bonnet. This may have been a short-lived attempt to establish this as the new Doctor's catchphrase, as the line was repeated during the studio recording for Episode 4. Some of the guest cast for the Highlanders had other notable links with Doctor Who. David Garth, who played Solicitor Grey, returned once more to Doctor Who, playing a very City Gent-style Time Lord in the John Pertwee story Terror of the Autons. Peter Welsh, who played the Redcoat Sergeant, appeared as Mr. Morgan in the Tom Baker story The Android Invasion. Dallas Cavell first appeared as the Overseer in the William Hartnell adventure The Reign of Terror, then as the prisoner called Bors in the Daleks' Master Plan. In The Highlanders, he returned to Doctor Who, this time playing Captain Trask, Captain of the Annabelle. He was to return to Doctor Who on a further two occasions. Firstly, as Sir James Quinlan in the John Pertwee story, The Ambassadors of Death. Interestingly, William Dysart, who played Alexander McLaren in The Highlanders, also appears as Regan in the same episode. Dallas Cavell's final Doctor Who was in a minor role as the head of security in Peter Davison's debut story, Castro Valva. Although ratings for The Highlanders were on a par with the previous two serials, this would be the final Doctor Who historical adventure for quite some time, with subsequent Earthbound stories being set on contemporary or future Earth. Although the use of historical settings for science fiction stories would not be discouraged, The Highlanders would be the last truly historical adventure for over 15 years until the Peter Davison story Black Orchid in 1982. Sadly, no episodes of The Highlanders survived the junking of archive material from the BBC in the 1970s. All that remains of this classic Doctor Who story are a few brief clips, recovered in 1996 from the Australian archives, that were cut prior to transmission.